Hey, slow down. I've been following you ever since the lake.
Oh my God, you're so gross. Get away from me.
Do you believe in love at first sight? Or should I swim by again?
Ew.
Do you work at Subway? Because you just gave me a foot long.
Ew.
Picture perfect, baby. High price, but I'm worth it, baby. Can't play with you, I've been busy working, baby. Getting faded in a European swerving act. Look, scrap Biggie, groundbreaking, what the word is. Hit the stage, ass shaking like I'm nervous. When in New York, I be poking around on medicine. This ain't no accident, I'm killing them on purpose. Gigi, why did she just ever do it, baby? Ride with me, fly living, ain't nothing to it. And my waist slim, ass fat, you gotta have it. Get my bacon, cake long, that's automatic.
Top of the morning to you. I'm Tony Romeo.
And I'm John Fields.
And this is Get Bent.
We're in the beautiful woods today, tributary of Wachusett Rise. We're fishing for the elusive landlocked salmon. We gotta be real quiet today. They have moved up from the lake into the river and want a spawn. So we have found a spot with a nice bed. So we're gonna stand on shore, out of sight, upriver.
John, what are we using today?
We're gonna use a night crawler, actually on a size 6 hook, and we're gonna drift the worm down. 4-pound test leader, fluorocarbon, running to an 8-pound high-vis yellow. 9-foot rod, very custom to any salmon rod, steelhead rod you'd use in any other situation. The reason for that is it gives you a little bit more of an angle over the water. As the salmon move upriver, the eggs and the females actually have a choking sensation for the fish. So a lot of times, if you've ever watched National Geographic, what happens is you see them, they're almost gasping for air, and that's because they cannot necessarily breathe correctly with all those eggs in them. So what we're doing is we're going to drift a night crawler, size 6 hook, 4-pound test, right down to them with a split shot, right down, and put it almost directly in their mouth, so as they are breathing, got them.
What you said.
How about we go catch some fish?
Let's get them. Let's get them. What we have here is a young female. As you can see from the egg sac down here, moved up the river to spawn. Hasn't been in the river too long. Still has that chrome purple look. As you can see from the, as the sun's starting to rise this morning, probably 14, 16. Beautiful.
It's a nice looking fish.
Beautiful.
Salmon?
Salmon, yeah.
Salmon.
As you can see from the hook, took it and turned their head. So they're notorious for taking the bait and turning.
That's a nice, that's a fat fish, bro.
It's tiny.
That is?
Tiny.
Is it?
S-turn, all the salmon were waiting to make the run, and we got her on that first bed, so this would be a second one up here, but I think we're all still waiting. The sun's just coming up, got some light, it's gonna be a good day.
Some people want me to be heads or tails. I say no way, try again another day. I should be happy, not tipping the scales.
I just won't play, letting my life get away.
I'm not a fool now, I'm not a follower. I don't take things as they come, if they bring me down. Life can be cruel, if you're a dreamer. I just wanna have some fun, don't tell me what could be done.
You know you like it, but it drives me insane. You know you like it, but it drives me insane. You know you like it, but you're scared of the shame.
What you want, what you gonna do?
You know you like it, but it drives me insane. Only because you know that you wanna feel the same. You know you like it, but it drives me insane.
What you want, what you gonna do? I just wanna have some fun.
Salmon trip was actually my first. Kind of a funny story, you know, growing up in Central Mass, fishing different lakes, different streams. You always heard of this salmon run coming out of the Wachusett Reservoir, which anyone from Central Mass knows it's a drinking water supply, and it's kind of one of those bodies of water that's, you have to know somebody to really kind of show you where to fish and how to fish it. I know that other parts of the country, the salmon run starts in about October, sometimes as early as September, and that comes on with the rains. So I kind of took the knowledge of those traditional salmon methods and basically those activator type of key components that contribute to the activation of this salmon run. So I really started in October, just walking the rivers, trying to see, talk to people, but a few weeks into it, I called John. I said, listen, bro, I found them, they're here.
So when Tony called me and told me we were going salmon fishing, I was like, yo, aren't salmon in the ocean? I had never heard of land salmon. You know, I don't know about them. I know there's like ocean salmon, right? That we get from Legal Seafoods. You know, or the sole proprietor has really good salmon, you know, don't know where it comes from, but apparently there are also these things called landlocked salmon, you know, that are locked in these lakes, and then they travel from the lake up the river to get down, I guess that's what they do, that's just what they do, it's in their genes or something. And I guess some of them actually travel when they spawn to the exact spot that they were born. The exact spot. I couldn't even tell you the state that I was born in, you know? So that to me was pretty crazy that the, you know, swimming around like all day and eating whatever, and then all of a sudden something clicks and it's like, oh, I need to go back to the spot right now. And it's just crazy that then they all go, you know, it's weird. That is some stuff. How do they know? How do they know where to go? They don't know how to use a map. There's no salmon navigation, you know? GPS. Geographic positioning salmon. No. No. Does not. So, whatever it is, that's cool part. That's not even science. That's nature. The original scientist. Mother Nature. What up, homies? Thank you very much for tuning in today. It appears that the fall salmon run has officially ended, as we were not able to locate one salmon all day.
It has officially ended, Tony.
It's sad. It's sad, John.
The lack of rain put the river down. They have officially migrated back to the reservoir, to their home, where they will now stay until the next season.
You know, we learned a lot out here. It was my first time salmon fishing. So, Tony, thank you very much for taking me out, showing me the ropes. I suck at it.
No.
But I'll
I'll take the things I learned from this experience, I will carry them into my next experience, you know? Fishing can teach you a lot about life in general.
The early bird gets the worm.
The early bird gets the worm. Up next, we will be coming back with some very exciting ice fishing. That's right, ice fishing. So bundle up, get your augers ready to go, and we'll see you soon. All right?
Next time on Get Bent TV.
We have just arrived at 18 Mile Creek.
I've seen browns come out of here tipping 16, 17. I mean, salmon 30 plus all day, every day in November. And we're starting to see our push of chromers coming up, which is our spring run.